Meet with Boxing Dude Robert Garcia, and today he's going to answer questions that you guys sent in. Check it out. What's the last question?
Last question is from Grant Frisbee again. How important is balance in boxing?
Balance makes a fucking big difference. You know, sometimes fighters finish up their combinations and they go off balance. Or Amir Khan is one of them. Come on, everybody sees that. He's boxing beautifully, but then he wants to throw and he goes. Throws his whole body into that's bad balance. And I've seen that since the first day I seen him fight until his last fight. He still has a problem. Maybe something nobody could correct. I don't know. I would try.
Bad habits.
I would try.
And that's it.
So Robert, thanks so much for answering all those questions. We got a lot of them within a matter of minutes. People are watching. They're paying attention. They're listening.
We have a lot of fucking haters.
That's okay. Haters are people too.
Who has the shirt right now?
I have the shirt.
Oh, you have that shirt.
Here, hold it. Show them. This is the Tim Bradley shirt after he beat Pacquiao. Haters. My haters and my motivators. Tim Bradley.
I think I go with that saying right there with Tim Bradley because I'm not saying around the world, but here in Oxnard, we get a lot of hate, right?
Of course.
Because this is the gym where everybody would love to be, and this is the gym that brings all the great fighters, and I do get a lot of hate.
Yeah, so you tell Mr. Garcia to remember what he said. Before he let anybody in here tell him anything about me, to come ask me first, because I know people tell him shit about me and I ain't said a word about none of that shit.
What?
That's because it's the other trainers, they feel like somebody's coming in and is overstepping them or some shit
you,
like that.
Dude, nobody hates you.
Everybody hates me.
He knows that.
Oh, are you kidding me? And I'm happy-go-lucky. And you know why I'm happy-go-lucky? Because most of the shit most of the shit that I learned in boxing, I learned
Akeem, you read the Bible?
A little bit. Couple scriptures.
You guys could all read the Bible.
Yeah. I read, but only the Old Testament.
Oh, sure.
Okay, that's
real. Yeah. My dad's a deacon.
What are the Ten Commandments?
You that one?
Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Yeah. Yeah.
False witness against thy neighbor.
I know that. Yeah, he's a preacher.
Don't honor thy mother, thy father.
Okay.
I'm trying.
Wait a minute. I got to start over again.
A little bit.
Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal.
Don't covet.
Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife.
Don't lie.
Thou shalt not lie.
False witness.
Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. And say it right. Rule number one is...
You lost three in the mix.
Oh, yeah. You tried to cut it out.
You should not have other gods.
No, I can't.
That's the first
thou
one.
Thou shalt not have no other gods before
that's
thee.
That's number one.
I shouldn't have had to tell you that one.
Well, that's... Okay.
That's the first commandment.
Because he forgot it.
Thou shalt not have no other... Oh, no.
Okay, but you're...
What remember you're, the Sabbath.
Bible, that's Christian? Is that...
No, true? There's no such that's thing a, as that.
No?
No, there's no... I think that... Look it. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Meaning that if you're a good person and you believe in God and you think Jesus died for your sins, which Jesus did die for our sins, because like he said, he follows the Old Testament. But what he doesn't realize is that when Jesus came and spilled his blood and died for us all, we were forgiven for all the bad things that we do. Like me slinging all that pipa in the nighttime. Oh, man.
I gotta ask you this. Do you see Tim Tebow posing like Jesus? What's your take on that?
Oh, wow. You know that soda? I think that's Elvis.
That is Elvis.
I need a drink right now. I'm feeling kind of... My sugar's on. Yeah?
He shook it.
What?
He shook it.
Yeah, but it's all right. My sugar is dropping right now. Yeah, I feel it, dude.
Hello, put you in the
I've been eating healthy. You know that, right?
Good.
I lost like 7 pounds already.
You did look like you lost weight.
Yeah, I've lost some weight.
Everybody in the gym lost weight.
People don't realize when they move.
By September 15th.
To me.
My goal is to be 170. I said 170.
You working on a comeback?
No. I weighed myself.
You weigh more than 170?
Dude, I was 185.
Yeah, I remember that day.
Yeah, I weighed, right? I weighed myself the other day. I'm like, 185. I'm like, what the fuck?
You better watch
my
blood pressure's gonna go up.
So right away, I said, fuck this. So I started, I've already lost like 7 pounds.
You're gonna know when your blood pressure goes up?
I'm already like 78. So by my Dana's fight, my goal was 170. I think I'm gonna be lighter. Who? Some guy from Argentina.
A guy with the tattoo
over
there.
How did he get in touch with you?
Huh?
How did he get in touch with you?
He called me. Look, so I said by that, and then for I said 170. Then for Brandon's fight, 2 weeks later, 165. But I think it's gonna be 165 and then 160. I think so, dude. Watch.
So there you have it. Stay tuned. Robert Garcia on a diet. Everybody, you're working out.
Yeah.
How about Bocinas right behind you?
Bocinas, how much did you lose?
Never relax.
Yeah. Look at Bocinas.
There's never.
Look at
you lost how much there that you could ever relax.
He lost 50 pounds.
You know that?
In a matter, in cuánto tiempo?
Yeah. 2 months.
Wow. Well, how much do you want to lose?
You can never relax in the ring with him. Never, never.
Do you want to be as big as Nestor?
Come back and take a break. If he hits you, take a step back.